I also welcome the industrial participants who are present here in the studio, and around 10 different centers in 3 different states have been connected. I welcome all the centers. In fact, I'll not be inviting the different guests from these centers because we are short of time, and straight away I'll be starting this session. Now this course, in fact, if we see IC engines have been planned earlier also, and in fact Dr. Poonia was the first to start this course, that is the technical courses at this institute, and it's the second course in line from Dr. Poonia that we are offering this. And IC engines, as you know, this technology is undergoing a drastic change in different parts of the country, and the latest development, you can see that France is the country which is thinking of banning the diesel engines from the next year onwards. It means it's putting excessive pressure on this type of technology. So that's why we thought of offering this course with what is the latest trends and what is the latest technology and what are the changes which are happening in this area. And in this context, this course we are offering along with the industry, and the industry is that is Embassy Technovations Private Limited, Gurgaon, and we have his expert, we have his owner, managing director, Dr. D.S. Khatri here, and our institute has signed an MOU with this industry in for collaborating with us, is not only in offering these courses but in other research projects where this industry is helping our students in taking up industrial projects in different areas in automobile sectors in Gurgaon. And I'm very thankful to Dr. D.S. Khatri, who is very much here, and he'll be, some of the portion will be taken care of by him. And Dr. Khatri, as you know, I have got just his brief biodata. He has completed his master's in thermal engineering from Delhi College of Engineering, Delhi, and PhD from IIT Delhi. And he's a visiting research fellow to a number of colleges in UK, and he has got a vast experience in his area. He has worked in Italy. He is right now, I told you that, having his own firm and offering consultancy to different industry automobile sector in Gurgaon. He was also the earlier technical head in Germany in one of the company and technical advisor to ESK Automotive. He's a founder director of this right on the present company, Embassy Technovations. And he has also guided not only the ME projects, but he has also guided PhD at IIT Delhi and has got number of patents to his credit. And coming to the department, that my department is offering these ICT courses. In fact, we started this year earlier. I told you that Dr. Poonia offered this ICNG last year. And this year, we are offering a number of courses through ICT. And we have already offered two such courses, one in Industrial Automation and Robotics in August and one in AutoCAD recently in November. And this, the right now, ICNG, especially on a special request of many institutions, we are offering. And we, in pipeline, there are three courses which will be offering through ICT, that is Advanced Manufacturing Methods in February, and two courses we'll be offering in March, that is Recent Trends in Automobile Engineering and CAD Using CATIA. Regarding this Recent Trends in Automobile Engineering, in which we'll be offering in March, again we'll be taking help of number of experts from this area, and we'll be also taking help of Dr. Khatri. And there we'll be covering more different aspects leading to the automobile technology. So not taking much time now, I'll in fact try to invite our director, Dr. M.P. Poonia, who's a well-known expertise in this area, well-known administrator, the personality which the northern region knows well. And I now invite Dr. Poonia to please briefly give his talk on this occasion. Yeah, in fact, just excuse me. Now, before I invite Dr. Poonia, I like to invite Dr. Khatri to throw some light on this 5 days program which we are offering on IC Engine, so that at least you know what are the different contents which he'll be covering in these 5 days. Dr. Khatri.
Thanks, Professor Benvet, Dr. Poonia, and Mr. Paula. And good morning to everyone, to all the centers which are connected through NITTR. The content of the present course, we are starting with the fundamentals of internal combustion engines. Then we are covering what are the basic needs of an internal combustion engines. And this I would like to start, you know, what is the best engines in the world available? That is our own body. And we will start and correlate the nature with the internal combustion engines. Like what we need, our basic requirement is air and any type of fuel, either we are taking carbohydrate, different proteins and all that. And then we are blending both and then we are converting those into energy. Similarly, engine is also a energy conversion machine which converts the chemical energy of the fuel into the mechanical energy. So these basics we will discuss, and the mixture preparation technique which has been used for these engines, that will be also elaborated. Like we will start with the carburetor, which has been used since last 100 years, but the circumstances, the environmental protection forced the researchers to say goodbye to the carburetor. And why it has happened so, we will discuss, we will throw some light on that also. And who has replaced the carburetor, that is the injection system. More precisely, we can say it is the electronic fuel injection system technology, which has been already playing a vital role in passenger cars, and in two-wheeler also it is going to play a vital role maybe in next few years. After the engine management system, we would like to have a demonstration about the engine management system concept, what type of sensors we are using, what type of actuators we are using, and what is the controls starting from the air intake till to the exhaust gases. This demonstration will brief you about the fundamentals of each and every sensors, what type of signals it is giving, what type of actuators we are using, like injector, whether it is peak hole type, it is saturated type, all these things we would like to discuss with you during the demonstration which will take place today afternoon. But tomorrow morning we will start with the combustion fundamentals, where we will initiate in spark ignition engines, how the spark is initiated in diesel engines, what is the combustion fundamentals, and what is the difference between petrol engine and diesel engine's combustion strategy. After this, we will arrive what are the causes of the pollutant formation, why CO is formed, why hydrocarbons are formed, why NOx is formed, and why particulate matter is formed. Because until and unless we don't understand the basic cause of formation, we cannot avoid it, we cannot control it. After understanding all this, we will also know what are the effect of these pollutant on the human body and on the nature, on the environment. These effects may be categorized as a local regional problems, this may be categorized as a global problems and country problems. So that will be also discussed. Like for example, CO level increase in the air may cause the headache. Why headache? NOx results in asthmatic problem, it reduces the lungs capacity. Why so? So all this will be discussed tomorrow morning. Then we will discuss the pollution is formed now, how to avoid it. Emissions control technology for each and every pollutant will be discussed, like how I can reduce CO emissions, how I can reduce hydrocarbon emissions, how we can reduce NOx and particulate matter. Not only these four pollutants, now automotive industry is forced to reduce the CO2 emissions also. Till now, CO2 was not considered as a pollutant. But in Europe, already a regulation has been passed according to which any vehicle cannot emit more than 120 gram of CO2 per kilometer. Today, we are emitting around 160 to 180 gram per kilometer. It means there is a pressure on the automotive industry, on the researcher, on the academics, on the engineers, on the scientists, how to reduce the CO2 emissions. The byproduct of CO2 reduction will be also, we have to increase the fuel economy. Because in 1 kilometer, how much quantity of fuel I am consuming, that is producing the CO2. If I will consume less fuel, means less CO2 formation. Some emphasis will be also given, okay, I have a technology to reduce the emissions, but the technology is sustainable, the technology is economical viable, because in India, we cannot put a technology which cost maybe 1 lakh rupees. The Indian cost is 1 lakh and the emissions control technology is also having the cost of 1 lakh rupees. So I cannot afford that. The country like India cannot afford that. So we will discuss those issues also. For example, to reduce the NOx, there are two concepts. One is the EGR, exhaust gas recirculation system. Another is urea addition in the exhaust system. Now different country, different regions, they are adopting different type of technology. In India, now the choice is there. First, I should know what are the different technology to reduce the NOx. Then I should understand the fundamentals of that. Then I should understand and evaluate which is more suitable for my country, which is more suitable for our environmental conditions, which is more suitable to our road and transport sector. Keeping driving behavior, keeping road conditions, keeping driving habits. Just give an example, the BMW has launched the car here. We will understand those concepts also from the engine point of view, that whenever that car is passing on the road, having the water of around 1 foot, engine damages. And that damage is called as hydrolocking. In Germany, in Japan, these people, they never face this problem. They say, sir, we have never faced this problem. Our car is one of the most wanted car in the world. But when that car, that technology is put on the Indian roads, it fails. It is a mercy. And the person who is spending 1 crore rupees on buying a car and he is standing on the road, you can just imagine what will happen. So we cannot get the transfer the technology. What is good in Germany may not be good in India. So that's why we will give the emphasis that what type of engine technology, what type of emissions control technology will be suitable for India. Another part, like till now we were not controlling the particulate matters. Now the concept is coming, diesel particulate filter. Okay, I can use the, and I will give you an idea, you know, what is the cost of these systems? Because when we are talking about the technology, one DPF only, I am not talking about the technology, one DPF cost around 45,000 rupees. If I am putting in a car, you can just imagine, and it is a only DPF, not the system. The system itself cost around 2 lakhs rupees to control the particulate matter. So we have to see, to throw the idea, what is the cost of the technology will provoke you. Can I identify another option, another technology which is cheaper, which is good for India? So that we have to discuss, and we will try to energize your neurons during these training sessions. After that, tomorrow after lunch, again from 2 to 4, we will demonstrate you all the technology of emissions control. How the NOx is controlled by using EGR. We have bring EGR valves. we have bought a ECU also, and what are the parameters, how the lift is varying, we will try to display on the laptop and we will show you how this technology works and how this technology is integrated in the engines and how it is effective. Similarly, particulate matter technology, that is a DPF, diesel particulate filter, I will show you that actual DPF which we have bought specially to show you, and then how that technology is to be integrated in the vehicle. And when the particulate matter is choked after some time, nobody is going to replace that because the cost is 50,000 rupees, 60,000 rupees, because the driving force to a customer is the fuel economy. He is not bothered about the pollutant from the car. But government agency, environmental protection agency, they are bothered about the environments. So if the DPF is choked, what will happen? Customer may remove it and you may throw it. Then what should be done? So we have developed a technology which will be mounted on the DPF, that is known as a active regeneration system. It means when the back pressure increases to a certain amount, appropriate quantity of fuel will be injected in the DPF, and that will oxidize all the particulate matter which is stored in the DPF. So that technology also we are going to display you. Next, third day, we are covering some aspect of the alternate fuels. Then we are getting an expert, Mr. Ajay Kashyap, for this. Again, he has got his degree from USA and he is a very innovative entrepreneur. All the CNG buses in Delhi are fitted by Green Fuel Company. So they will talk about the piping, about the pressure regulator and all these things. Then we have a session from how to reduce the friction from the internal combustion engines. That is from IIT Delhi. Professor R.K. Pandey is expert in that area. He will emphasize how we can improve the fuel economy by reducing the frictional losses. And next day, Professor Poonia, Dr. Poonia is taking about the basic performance of the engines, how we can enhance the performance. Then Dr. Ramesh from IIT Chennai is talking about the two-stroke engine. He will talk about the downsizing of the engines. Now the concept is I can keep one engine and by doing the turbocharging or supercharging, I can enhance the torque and power characteristics of the engines. That will be discussed by Dr. Ramesh on the fourth day. And on the fifth day, he will discuss about the unconventional engines, the engine technology which is not very popular in automotive, but like Wankel engines, step piston engines, all this technology will be discussed by Dr. Ramesh. And then hybrid concept, hybrid vehicles, because in India the main problem is idling period is increasing day by day, the traffic congestion is increasing. So what is happening, we have done a research in Delhi, 58% period of total during journey is spent on idling. Suppose I am running my car for 2 hours, almost 1 hour is going in a idling. You can just imagine if there are millions of cars, 1 hour idling, that will result in million liters of fuel consumption. Million liters of fuel consumption during one day. And significant amount of pollutants, COHC. The concept is during idling, engine should shut off. That is a hybrid. I can operate on the electric system, and when I drive, I can operate with the internal combustion engine. So those are the things, all these issues will be addressed, and then on the fifth day, we have the conclusions. And this is, I think, a brief about this internal combustion program, which is, I appreciate that it is initiated by Dr. M.P. Poonia, and this is the need of the hours, that because engine and automotive, we should not understand that this is belongs to mechanical engineer or this belongs to electrical engineer. We have to change that thought. Any tech, because why we are not able to, you know, come up with the technology? Because what we think, it is a mechanical task, it is an electronic task, It is an electrical engineering task. It is a metallurgy person task. It is a rubber person task. It is a chemical engineering task. No. Automotive engineer is a blend of all engineering. Mechanical engineers cannot do anything, only one mechanical. Electronics is required, software is required, hardware is required, chemist is required, rubber, plastics, fuel, the starting point. What is the fuel technology? It is all chemical engineering. What is CNG? Compression ratio, knocking, a chemical expert is required. So it is a blend. So we have to come together. All the discipline has to come together to develop a technology, to develop a system. And the internal combustion is a one technology which is capable to involve all the discipline in one area. And with this, I thanks NITTR and special thanks to Professor M.P. Poonia to give us the opportunity to interact with you, to share with you the emerging trend on the internal combustion engines, and hope this course will be beneficial to all the participants. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Khatri. In fact, he has given us a good insight about this 5 days program, and I hope your participant will be naturally benefited by the content which is delivered in this course. And now I'll invite Dr. Poonia to share his thought for this course. Dr.
Good morning. Thank you, Professor Benvit, Professor Pabla, Professor Sachan, Dr. Khatri, participants at ETV Studio, my team members at ETV Studio, participants at different centers. First of all, on behalf of NITTA Chandigarh, I welcome you all, and I hope this 5 days program on internal combustion engines will be a wonderful addition in your knowledge. Many issues Professor Khatri was discussing. Major four themes which we want from an engine, which he has discussed. One, from a given size of engine, we want maximum output, or always our efforts are to reduce the size of the engine. Second one, we want that noise of the engine should be minimum, means comfort when we are riding a vehicle, comfort should be maximum. Third one, it's exhaust emissions which are there, it should be minimum. And fourth one, fuel consumption. Four major areas. First, I'm saying the size should be minimum. Second one, it's noise, it should be noise free, ride should be very comfortable. Third one, we are saying that exhaust emission should be minimum. Fourth one, fuel consumption should be minimum. Those major areas are there. In India, if you see, we are third largest country, which means total number of vehicles which are being produced in the world. Out of that, if I'm comparing, we are third largest manufacturer of vehicles. The amount of fuel which we are consuming in India, it is around 2% of the world's consumption. Americans are using around 50%. Total petroleum products which world is using, out of that, only 2% we are using. They are using 50%. Even if you are using 2%, still we are saying our environmental conditions are very bad, very bad. If you go to Bangalore, as he was discussing about the particulate matters, 50% people in Bangalore are asthmatic. And main reason is the particulate matters, which is coming mainly due to sulfur contents which are available in diesel. The Bangalore has become asthma capital of India. Same is the situation of Delhi. Delhi particularly, we are suffering from fog. That is the chemical which is floating in atmosphere. It is in more or less, it is visible just like a fog, but it is smoke. And any tragedy may be just like Bhopal's tragedy. It is very near. I think we are unable to predict that type of situation may come. Population of Delhi is increasing by 4% every year, and number of vehicles are increasing by 24%. I am saying population of Delhi is increasing by 4%, number of vehicles every year is increasing by 24%. Where will be parking them? How will be managing them? As already is saying that idling time is 58%. Idling time means when we are waiting on the red lights. That time engine is in switch on position, but we are waiting on the red light, no output we are getting, it is not moving at all. And it is happening, we are having metro, we are having many bridges, we are having everything, we have every effort we have done, but still this type of situation is coming. So because in every subject the problems are many. students or the requirement of the industry, the latest technologies, latest knowledge to the students has to be. If I'm comparing 20 years back, the teaching of internal combustion engine and today's teaching of internal combustion engines, it is something different. It's very, very different. The type of controls which is discussing about engine controls or exhaust emission control or even tire pressure control, everything which is coming into picture, the teaching is becoming difficult for everyone. So the area which I'll be discussing, I may not be touching in this inaugural session, how this internal combustion engine has to be taught, but at least how teaching can be made interesting. So the students can take interest into this one, because now complications are increasing. However, they are having many, many sources are also there. Long back when myself and Dr. Khatri were doing PhD at IIT Delhi, that time, even having these type of programs, attending these type of programs, taking knowledge through these type of programs, it was just impossible. It was just dream. Even this internet, the Google, the SA journal, getting them, it was very, very difficult. So literature was not available, books were not available, these technologies were not available. So that time there was no guidance. At this particular juncture, we people are very lucky that people like Dr. Khatri are available with us, who can interact with us and who can share their knowledge which they are facing, which they are going through in the industries. So this program which we have framed, I'll be extending my sincere thanks to Professor Benwet and Professor Pabla that they have taken a lot of pain. And in this 5 days program, what they have planned, that industry should be there, the R&D organization, IIT should be there, and we people who can deal the fundamentals of the subject, industry people will be dealing that what exactly industries are doing in internal combustion engine, and IIT people, they'll be telling us that what research is going on. So it's a combination, it's a rare combination where fundamentals, where research part and the application part is being covered in 5 days. So I hope that with the help of Dr. Khatri and our mechanical engineering department, it will be a wonderful gain in our knowledge. Just Indian situation, if you see, and particularly higher education, if I'm seeing, in higher education, every day, 5,000 students are added into higher education. When I'm saying higher education, means education which is after 12th. After 12th, the education which we are imparting, that is higher education, it's a huge country, huge population base. We are second largest country as far as population is concerned. Our population is around 1.21 billion after China, which they are having 1.35 billion. After that one, we are the largest country in population. 5,000 students are adding every day. 9 new institutes are coming up every day. At present, we are having around 42,000 colleges in India. More than 700 universities we are having, and every day 9 more are being added. So you can imagine how many students, how many institutes are being added into this system. And our gross enrollment ratio still is only 22%. Meaning of this one is, suppose 100 students have passed in 12th class examination, out of those 100, only 22 are entering into higher education. When I'm saying higher education, it is not only engineering education, every type of education which is being imparted in the colleges. So it is only 22%, 78% still they are not getting the opportunity. So in time to come, and by the efforts of the government of India, this 22% has to be increased by 38% end of this 5-year plan. So use possibilities, severe possibilities of expansion of this higher education is in time to come. At present, around 25 million students are studying in higher education. 25 million means aapke 2.5 crore bachche higher education mein pad rahe. It is more than, means 1.5 times the population of Australia. These many students are passing every year. And number of institutes, I am saying 42,000. So this traditional class teaching which earlier we had, students were sitting, teacher was there, and class was teacher centric class. Teacher was dominating. Those type of scenes were there, but now number of students are increasing. The conventional concepts of teaching which we had, now it is not working. Now in NITs, if you see, long back the class size was 40 students. Now class size is more than 120 students. Handling 120 students with conventional methods, it is becoming quite difficult also. And country is facing serious problems of teachers. We are having a huge shortage of teachers. So the class management, the number of students to whom we let to touch, that number is increasing. Even today's program, if you see, I think 10 centers are connected, like 3-4 more will be connected. On an average, if 20 teachers are sitting at one place, so around 300 students, 300 teachers will be covering through this program. So this size of classrooms are coming up. managing these type of these size of classrooms, again it is becoming a difficult task for the teachers. This is the smart classroom. The conventional classrooms I have shown you, this is traditional classrooms which we are using. Now this is the classroom. If you go on MIT website, their videos, if you see the class sizes of 10,000 students. If you go to BITS Pilani, class size is 1,000 students. NIT Jaipur, if you see, most of the classrooms which they are now constructing, it is of the class size of 500 students. So these type of classrooms is the modern trend, in fact. Conventional automobiles which we are having, this was conventional automobile. Just we were having a boiler where steam was getting generated, the steam was going on in the cylinders, it was forcing the piston, and the thermal efficiency of this type of engine was only 2 to 3%. No controls, no mechanism, nothing was there. So even teaching of these type of mechanism was easier as compared to this one, as compared to this one. If I'm going to today's automobile, where teaching by teachers has to be, how many controls are there? Lot of micro, many microprocessors, even they are controlling the fuel supply, fuel injection, and the input from the atmosphere, the pressure, temperature, the throttle position, everything. According to that one, even smallest drop of the fuel is getting controlled by microprocessor. Even through exhaust, what is coming, as Dr. Khatri was saying, now not only CO, not only oxides of nitrogen, not only unburnt hydrocarbons, even CO2 is becoming a problem, because it is affecting our temperature of the environment, which is, we are saying, global warming is taking place. And this century, this 21st century, it is hoped that temperature of Earth will be increasing by 5 degrees Celsius. So normal temperature in Rajasthan, if you go, normal temperature in the month of May, it is 48-49. If you add 5 degrees Celsius into that one, the temperature will become 54 degrees Celsius. How someone will survive at 54? How plantation, how agriculture, how we'll be doing? So it will be a very tough time if we won't be controlling the CO2. I'm saying we are consuming only 2% of the petroleum products, but CO2 emission of India is highest, it is largest in the world. So whatever impact will be coming, severe impact will be coming, that will be coming India only. It is hoped that during this 21st century, even the sea level will be increasing by 75 centimeter. If it will be rising by 75 centimeter, then lot of water will be coming on Earth. The cities like Bombay or some of the cities in Gujarat, they'll Venice, in fact, no cities will be available which is very near to the sea. So situation in time to come is becoming quite grim, and if we won't be controlling now, the situation will be very, very difficult, where no one can control. So I'm saying, teaching modern automobile, we need modern technology, modern tools, modern techniques, ICT facilities we'll have to have, so that we can do justice with these friends. Even today's The available facilities with the students which are there. Long back, only teacher was the source of knowledge. Now, many areas are there, many sources are there from where students are getting the information. Suppose today I started to teach fundamentals of IC engines. In first lecture I'm teaching. Next day when I'm entering into the class where I'm facing 125 students, related to that topic, many new things they have studied through Google, and they'll be coming in the class. If I'm not prepared, as a teacher, students won't permit me to stand in front of them. So teachers has to be prepared. Otherwise, doing justice with the students, it's very difficult. So it is being said, this Nobel Prize winner in 1993, Robert, is saying, today's class, it's very difficult to find out that who is teacher. Teacher is dominating or students are dominating. Out of students and teacher, if I'm comparing who is teacher, it's very difficult to find, because source of knowledge, source of information which students are having, that is huge. And the level of teacher and level of student is certainly different, undoubtedly. The teacher is boiling at different temperature, student is boiling at different temperature. Means they are receiving the information from the teachers. So level of the teacher is higher, level of the teacher student is lower. So first of all, the quality of a good teacher, he'll have to reach up to the level of the students, and at that level he should be able to deliver. Now both the levels, the boiling temperature of teacher and boiling temperature of students, which is at a lower, I'm saying both the temperature should become same, boiling temperature should become same. It should be just like sublimation situation. Sublimation means just from solid to the vapor, it is being converted at certain temperature, it is getting converted. So the sublimation type situation should be that both teacher and both student should come at one particular level, and then exchange of knowledge has to be, then only the controlling of the students and the utility of the teacher can be proved. If your teacher is at a very high level, students are at a very low level, the synchronization is very, very difficult. So first suggestion to the teachers from my side is, please come to the level of the students. If you want to manage the class of 120 students, management will be possible only if you are always moving, if you are always floating at the level of the students. So this in the history, the role of the teacher and today's teacher's role, it is very, very difficult. Teachers are passing through a very tough time, where quality of students, the resources with the students which they are having, it is much more. So the role of teacher is becoming important. Even situation of teacher is becoming something very different. So most talented students we people are facing. So certainly the level of teachers should continuously grow. They should be the long life learner. Life learners they should be. Then only they can survive in front of the students. So classroom management, when I'm saying, meaning of the classroom management is, whatever I'm teaching, that should be received by the students. Whatever knowledge I'm extending to the students, that should be received by the students. That is termed as classroom management. Main jo padha raha hun, mere paas jo contents hai, main jo deliver kar raha hun, usko students receive kar paye, achhi tarah se receive kar paye, they should feel satisfied, they should feel that we are gaining something. So if that type of situation we are able to create, that is termed as classroom management. But most of the time, what is happening? Most of the times, the observations which we people are having, students are not taking interest. In the classes, they are just like sleeping. They are having the mobile, so they are having another type of books which may not be related to your subjects. They are busy in those areas. So the classroom can become interesting. These type of situations should not be. And it will not be if we people are prepared and we are working at the level of the students. Even lot of indiscipline is also being observed, fighting within teachers and students, lot of unrest, even related to marks, related to results, indiscipline activities inside the class is being also observed. It means there is a severe gap between the way we people are teaching and the way it is being received. And it is also being said that teachers are not taking their job seriously. If they are taking their job seriously, these type of situations, the unrest or indiscipline which is being observed, it won't be. So teachers should also be very, very serious. If they won't be serious, they'll be vanished. And teacher, agar aapko yahan India mein nahi milenge, kami rahegi, to China se aa jayenge, aapke jo hai US se aa jayenge. Someone will be teaching to Indian students, because lot of hope from these students, whole world is looking towards India, particularly our talented manpower. So if we people won't be serious, someone will be there from outside, because 90% education in India is in private hands. If we people won't be delivering, some outsiders will be delivering. Someone has to deliver, in fact. So, but at present, it is being said that most of the teachers even are not serious towards their job. And what are the reasons why students are misbehaving? One thing about our curriculum. As Professor Khatri is discussing, he is discussing very high tech technologies. But in classes which we are teaching, particularly internal combustion engines, still we are concentrating on two-stroke engines. In 1970 somewhere, Japan has banned these two-stroke engines. But India is dependent upon two-stroke engines. Majority of the vehicles which we are having, it is of two-stroke. So the curriculum which we are having and actual the requirement of the industries are, it is something different. Suppose some student has studied here in India, he is studying most of the times two-stroke engines, but when he is entering into Japan or entering into US, there is no technology related to that one. So whatever contents he has studied, it is not of the use of those countries. So one particular thing and due to which students are not taking interest, our curriculum is outdated. We are teaching steam engines to them. The speed of the steam engines were 20 kilometers per hour. But now our Prime Minister is talking about pilot train, which will be moving at the speed of 350 kilometers per hour. We are teaching the technology which was meant for 20 kilometers per hour speed, and actual requirement is 350 kilometers per hour. So whatever is being taught and whatever is actually required, there is a huge difference. And second one, inability to understand the concepts, fundamentals. If you want to make any subject interesting, first of all, fundamentals should be clear. So first role of the teacher is, suppose I am having a class of 60 students, first of all, I'll have to create the interest of the students in that particular subject. If I could create the interest of the students in that particular subject and then I am imparting the training, if I am training, giving training to them, it will be much more useful. So foremost thing, foremost quality of a teacher has to be that he should be able to create interest in that particular subject. And third, again, teachers. The teachers are not able to do justice with the students. That is, again and again, this situation is coming in front of us. So our target is students should dream. हम ऐसा माहौल बनाएं क्लास में जो स्वप्न लेना शुरू कर दें. आज आपने बात की, डॉक्टर खत्री बात कर रहे हैं कि ऐसा कोई स्टूडेंट अगर एक इंजन की एफिशिएंसी, थर्मल एफिशिएंसी 1% इंक्रीज कर देता है, ही विल बी द रिचेस्ट पर्सन इन द वर्ल्ड. 1% एफिशिएंसी, पेट्रोल इंजन की एफिशिएंसी 25% अगर थर्मल एफिशिएंसी है, इफ समवन कैन क्लेम दैट फ्रॉम 25 to 26% आई कैन डू बाय modifying the engine parameters, he'll be the richest person in the world. So that type of dream, if teacher can create that, you can increase the efficiency from 25 to 26%. Aise dream agar lana aapne dimag mein shuru kar diya, then hundreds of new things he'll be having in his mind and interest will be created and then up to depth he'll be going. So aapka teacher ka kaam jo hai, unke dimag mein jo hai dream leke aana. Teaching jo hai scientific, now teaching is very very scientific. It is not 30 years back where class size was 10 students. That was not scientific teaching. It was one way transmission only. Now it is two way, more or less from other side this transmission is. So role of teacher is becoming very very important and teachers always has to say, will have to make the confidence in the students. Student ke dimag mein ye aana hai ki we can do. We can dream and whatever we are dreaming, we can do. If those type of situations can be created from teacher's side, I think situation can change. So, are they dreaming? Foremost thing is the type of environment in the class we'll have to create where we'll be saying the students are dreaming. Dekho aap, jo teaching hai, teaching ka maine dikhaya, aaj jo chote chote engine, chote chote model banana, jo left hand side mein aapko dikh raha hai, chote chote model bana ke, alke alke jo hai, apan students ko dikha sakte hai, and teaching can become very very interesting. आप complicated जो steam engine दिखाने की बजाय अगर आप छोटा सा स्वरूप class में ले जाके दिखाएंगे, so teaching will be interesting. We'll have to create interest of the students. ऐसे प्रयास करें आप जो है. अगर load दिखाना, overloading दिखाना है engine पे, आप overloading इस तरह से दिखाइए, जिससे उनको physically पता चले what is overloading on the engine. If engine is getting overloaded, you can see the exhaust level of exhaust, particularly diesel engine, black smoke is coming out. Why it is coming out? The load has increased, and it should be correlated with the practical things. If you are teaching them horsepower, you teach like this one. One horse is raising weight out of 75 kg. It is raising to 1 meter in a 1 second. If it is possible, it is equal to 1 horsepower. So, if these type of examples we can give, the subject will become interesting. So, foremost task with the teachers is to make subject interesting so that students can dream. एक कंसेप्ट में बताता होता हूं स्टूडेंट्स को, डीजल और पेट्रोल इंजन का. डीजल इंजन क्या है, पेट्रोल इंजन क्या है, दोनों किस तरह से काम करते हैं. द एग्जांपल व्हिच आई एम गिविंग व्हेन आई एम टीचिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट, आई एम सेइंग इन ए पेट्रोल इंजन द फ्यूल एंड एयर व्हिच इज एंटरिंग इनटू द सिलेंडर, इट इज हैविंग इनफ टाइम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ मिक्सिंग. देयर इज अ होमोजेनियस मिक्सिंग ऑफ एयर एंड फ्यूल वेपर्स ऑफ द पेट्रोल इनसाइड द कार्बोरेटर. दैट होमोजेनियस मिक्सचर इज एंटरिंग इनटू द सिलेंडर in the suction stroke. So proper mixing is there. When it is being entered into the cylinder during suction stroke, enough time it is having, then it is being compressed, still lot of time is there even before start of combustion, and end of the compression somewhere near TDC we are producing this spark, and then flame is propagating. So enough time is available, preparation time is available. In contrary to this, in the case of diesel engine, just air we are taken inside the cylinder during suction stroke, we are compressing that one, and very near to top dead center, without giving time, we are injecting the diesel into the cylinder, and immediately after injection, the combustion somewhere inside the cylinder, combustion is getting started. So time available for mixing this diesel and air is not enough time. No preparations are there. Without preparations, things are getting started, and that's why problem in diesel engine, particularly related to smoke, enough problems are there. So the comparison which I'm giving for petrol and diesel engine, I'm saying petrol engine is just like arranged marriage. Arranged marriage hoti hai, usme kya karte hain, pehle se jo rishta tay karte hain, card chhapwate hain, mehmanon ko bulate hain, and everything is in a proper way. So the behavior of petrol engine is correlated with arranged marriage. But in the case of diesel engine, without preparation, without thinking, no planning, no objective we have fixed, no mandate we have taken from anyone, even parents se bhi mandate nahi leta. So diesel engine jo behave karta hai, it is just like court marriage. Court marriage mein ladka ladki registrar ke samne gaye, unhone jo hai apna registration kara liya, no one is in between, even some fight will be there in future, no one will be there to save them. So the stability of petrol engine is much more, wo arranged marriage hai, and डीजल इंजन की स्टेबिलिटी जो है आपकी कम है बिकॉज इट इज अनप्लान्ड वे. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स इफ यू आर गिविंग योर सब्जेक्ट कैन बिकम मच मोर इंटरेस्टिंग. एक मैं रिपोर्ट आपको जो जस्ट मैं एक एग्जाम्पल दूंगा अपने को प्रैक्टिकल कैसे लिखना है. जस्ट व्हाट एफर्ट आर ट्राइड टू डू फॉर राइटिंग ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट. मैंने जो प्रयास किया इन द क्लास इन व्हेन 20 स्टूडेंट्स आर कमिंग टू यू क्लास साइज इन एनआईटी से 120 स्टूडेंट्स सो इन लैब 20 स्टूडेंट्स आर कमिंग वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. नॉर्मली व्हाट वी आर डूइंग वी आर गिविंग ए मैनुअल टू देम. 3 hours क्लास इज देयर. आउट ऑफ 3 hours 1.5 hours दे आर बिजी इन राइटिंग इन द लेबोरेटरी. कुछ काम नहीं कर रहे हैं वो मैनुअल दे दिया उसको लिख रहे हैं. टीचर इज सीटिंग इन ए कॉर्नर. आई हैव ट्राइड टू एबोलिश दिस वन. आई सेड आई वॉन्ट गिव एनी मैनुअल टू यू. Just go on the engine, come with me. Whatever minimum will be required, formula, everything for calculating efficiency, load, everything I'll be giving to you. Just start your experimental work in front of me. I'll be the observer of that one. I'll be the guide of yours. You please do these things. These steps are there. You please do. And everything, even calculation, everything they'll be able to finish in 2 hours. No writing, nothing is there. Aapne minimum cheeze unko de di, aapne saath mein baith ke unka guide banke, you are done. Remaining 1 hour, you allow the students to sit in the laboratory, close everything, sit in the laboratory. You also become the part, teacher is also becoming the part, and ask one by one student that whatever you learnt in 2 hours, you please explain here. Do 3 minute ka time dijiye unko. So one, their agitation will go. Another one, during those 2 hours, they'll be very serious because they'll have to explain in front of you. So that's that type of effort I tried. And after completion of 3 hours, I said, you go into the hostels, whatever you have learned today, you write in the form of a research paper. आप जैसे पेपर लिखते हैं, आप चाहे टू स्ट्रोक इंजन पे आपने जो लोड टेस्ट किया है उसको एक रिसर्च पेपर की फॉर्म में लिख दीजिए. किस तरह से? जस्ट यू राइट योर ऑब्जेक्टिव, देन यू राइट डाउन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ दैट वन. एब्स्ट्रैक्ट उन्होंने लिखा और ये जो पिंक लिख रहा है, they used to send me through mails whatever they are writing 6 pages. They are going on Google, they are going on journal, they are searching some books and related to two stroke engine they are writing. So this pink which is available, that these are my comments. So after writing they used to send to me through mail. Isme jo koi bhi kamiya hai, jo comment ka option hai apne word ke andar, I was correcting that one, I was sending back to them. So they are writing title, they are writing the abstract, they are writing the literature review, they are writing the experimental setup, then observation table, then calculation, then finally results discussion, and even finally references also, from where they have taken this material, even references they are writing. So their writing skills are increasing, as well as the depth into the subject. They'll be entering into the deep of the subjects for the purpose of learning, because they'll have to submit. So everything in the form of research paper, and I used to send my comments wherever some changes are needed. Yes, everything in the form of research paper. ये देखो आप जितना भी आपको मेहनत तो काफी करनी पड़ी है क्योंकि आपको सारा चेक करके वापस every student you have to send. You are having 120 students in one semester. You are having 10 experiments. So number of mails which you are receiving, that is 120 multiplied by 10, 1200 mails you will be receiving, and you will be replying. The advantage was. Advantage with this was that students has started to search the result, search the literature, interest has been created, and after doing 3-4 experiments, they started to suggest me, sir, that in place of doing this experiment like this one, this experiment को अगर ऐसे करते अपन, that would have been better. मतलब students की तरफ से आपको suggestion आने लग गए, they have become just like teachers of you, they are guiding you, and I observed after doing 7-8 experiments, these conventional write-ups. They have started to present in seminars also. Choti-choti seminar mein unhone jana shuru kar diya. And when recruitment drive is there, when industries are coming for the purpose of placement, most of the time they are asking what is your subject of interest. So, kyunki unhone itna study kar liya tha, sab kuch study kar liya tha, immediately they were saying, sir, ki mera IC engine, isme kuch bhi pooch lijiye. Is tarah ka agar aap mahol create kar dete hain, the understanding will be much more. And today's students, the biggest challenge which we are having, their writing skills are going down. राइटिंग क्या कर रहे हैं, वो एसएमएस की लैंग्वेज में लिख रहे हैं. दे आर हैबिचुअल टू राइट एसएमएस इन प्लेस ऑफ वाई ओ यू, दे आर राइटिंग यू. सो इफ दिस टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिज्म वी कैन डिवाइस, इफ दिस टाइप ऑफ एक्सरसाइजेस वी कैन गिव, आई थिंक दिस प्रॉब्लम कैन बी सॉर्टेड आउट. बट द लोड ऑन द टीचर विल बी इंक्रीजिंग जस्ट बाई डूइंग नौकरी. आप जो है चाहो कि इस तरह से कर दें वो नहीं. एवरी मिनट ऑफ यूर लाइफ यू हैव टू बी विद द स्टूडेंट्स, देन ओनली दीज चेंजेस यू कैन डू. So, attention of the students are important, willingness of the students are important, and insight in every student from teacher side, it's very, very important. And towards teachers, towards students, always be polite, be positive, and helpful to them. We are not the inspectors, in fact. Students pe hum inspector nahi hai. Hamara role ek guide ka hona chahiye, hamara role ek parent ka hona chahiye, hamara role ek facilitator ka hona chahiye. Itta. इस तरह का हो. चाहे यू मे बी अ वेरी वेरी हार्ड टीचर, यू मे बी वेरी वेरी रूड ऑल्सो, बट इफ स्टूडेंट्स आर थिंकिंग दैट यू आर वेरी ट्रांसपेरेंट, यू विल बी डूइंग जस्टिस विद द स्टूडेंट्स. आपका बिहेवियर चाहे रूड हो स्टूडेंट्स के प्रति, आप चाहे बिल्कुल रफ हो, आप अपने प्रिंसिपल्स पे बंधे हुए हो, इफ यू आर ट्रांसपेरेंट स्टूडेंट्स विल बी हैविंग फेथ ऑन यू. नो इनडिसिप्लिन विल बी ऑब्जर्व इफ यू आर ट्रांसपेरेंट. इनडिसिप्लिन सिचुएशंस आर कमिंग इफ यू आर बायस्ड, इफ यू आर नॉट ट्रांसपेरेंट, if you are not doing justice with the students, then these situations are coming. So whatever the size of the class may be, if we are transparent, the things will be something different. मैं बताता हूँ, एक छोटी सी कहानी बताता हूँ आपको कि आपके लिए सबसे important क्या है, आपका subject कितना important है. एक philosopher ने एक एक boat किराए पे ली, घूमने के लिए एक boat किराए पे ली, समुद्र में चल पड़े. जो है boat को चलाने वाला था वो illiterate था, और फिलोसोफर जो बहुत बहुत एजुकेटेड था, जैसे वो चलते जा रहे थे समुद्र में, चलते जा रहे थे, फिलोसोफर ने उस बोट चलाने वाले को पूछा कि आपने जीवन दर्शन पढ़ा है क्या, आपने ग्रामर पढ़ी है क्या, क्या आपने जीवन को समझा है क्या. दैट पुअर फेलो ही सेड सर नथिंग, आई हैव नॉट स्टडीड एनीथिंग, मैं तो जन्म से ही जो है ये नाव चलाने का काम करता हूं, आज तक भी ये करता जा रहा हूं, आप जैसे बड़े लोग आते हैं उनको मैं ले जाता हूं, वापिस ले आता हूं. फिलोसोफर सेड योर हाफ लाइफ हैज गॉन, आपने आधा जीवन ऐसे ही गंवा दिया क्योंकि आपने जीवन दर्शन नहीं पढ़ा है, आपके पास वो ज्ञान नहीं है जो मेरे पास है जीवन दर्शन का. आफ्टर सम टाइम द सी बिकेम अनस्टेबल, स्टॉर्म आया, तूफान आने लगा उसके अंदर, नाव अनस्टेबल होने लगी. नाव का जो जो चलाने वाला था उसने फिलोसोफर से पूछा, डू यू नो स्विमिंग, उन्होंने कहा नहीं मैं तो जीवन दर्शन जानता हूं, स्विमिंग नहीं जानता. ही सेड योर होल लाइफ हैज गॉन, माई हाफ लाइफ वॉज गॉन बिकॉज मैं जीवन दर्शन नहीं जानता था, बट यू डोंट नो स्विमिंग, योर होल लाइफ हैज गॉन, अब आप डूबोगे जो. सो फॉरमोस्ट टास्क इज योर कंसेंट्रेशन, योर कॉन्फिडेंस, जो जिस फील्ड में हो उसमें आपकी महारत हासिल होनी चाहिए. आपको जीवन दर्शन से क्या लेना है, दर्शन तो जो लोगों को देना है, आपके पास ज्ञान जो है वो बांटना है, वो ज्ञान ऐसा होना चाहिए यू शुड बी 100% परफेक्ट इन दैट. मैन ए टीचर विदाउट इंस्पिरेशन, इफ ही इज टीचिंग without inspiration to the students, without knowing what they are able to understand or not, no inspiration if he is giving, it is just like hammering cold iron. Thande iron pe aap hammer marte raho, kuch bhi change nahi hoga till you'll not be hitting that one. Heating means you are inspiring the students. Heating iron means you are inspiring the students. So foremost thing is inspiration to the students and insight into the students. Inside a class, your physical position should be that you should be able to have eye contact with every student. Continuously, you should be able to move into the class, and involvement of the students is very, very important. Students should be involved. You should achieve excellence in your subject, in your area. That excellence should be sustained also. Today, I'm suppose excellent in ICE engines. Tomorrow, I may not be because everything is changing. So excellence has to be maintained also, it has to be sustained, and whatever excellence I am having, I should be able to exchange with others also. Whatever knowledge I am having, if I am unable to exchange with the students or with my colleagues, there is no use of that excellence. So achieving excellence, maintaining that excellence, and sharing that excellence is very, very important. From the students, we'll have to have very high expectations, and we'll have to say, you people can do. Just example of this eagle, say. Eagle is very, very confident. Very confident. Eagle always flies with eagle. Eagle किसी दूसरी पक्षियों के साथ कभी नहीं उड़ता है. And highest level it can achieve. Even when adverse situations are there, when rain is there, when storm is there, most of these birds are going into their nests, but this eagle won't go. It is going above the क्लाउड्स, जहां से प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट होती है उससे ऊपर चली जाती है. नो नो अफेक्ट ऑन द सिचुएशन ऑफ दिस ईगल इज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फ्रॉम दिस ट्रेंड्स वी लेट हैव हाई एक्सपेक्टेशन जस्ट लाइक ईगल कि किसी भी तरह के एडवर्स सिचुएशन को वो फेस कर पाए. एंड सेकंड वन बी फोकस्ड. इट कैन सी अप टू 5 kilometers. ऑलवेज इट रिमेन्स फोकस्ड. The eagle can see 5 kilometer distance it can cover. Our students should be very, very focused. They should be very confident. They should be focused just like eagle. And eagle don't want old things. Iske pankh bhi ye bar bar apne aap change kar leti hai. Naye pankh le aati hai. Ye apne chonch ko bhi tod ke nayi chonch bana leti hai. Ye apne panjon ko bhi tod ke naya bana leti hai. It don't want old curriculum. Jo teachers bhi aise honi chahiye. कि जो जो ईगल से सीखें कि ये पुरानी चीजें रखना पसंद नहीं करती. सो आवर करिकुलम चेंज इन करिकुलम इन सच ए वे सो दैट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स कैन बी क्रिएटेड. इट शुड बी जस्ट लाइक ईगल ओनली. आवर करिकुलम शुड बी जस्ट लाइक ईगल ओनली. एंड इन एडवर्सिटी इट इज अज्यूमिंग एट अपॉर्चुनिटी. व्हेन स्टॉर्म्स आर देयर दैट प्रेशर ऑफ एयर इट इज यूटिलाइजिंग फॉर मूविंग एट हायर एल्टीट्यूड्स. यस दैट एडवर्सिटी इट इज क्रिएटिंग इट इज कन्वर्टिंग इनटू पॉजिटिविटी ऑफ दैट वन. एंड देन कमिटमेंट. इसका कमिटमेंट देखो आप. जब ये अपना दोस्त बनाती है फीमेल, जब मेल को दोस्त बनाती है तो क्या करती है, ये ऊपर उड़ती उड़ती कुछ छोटी छोटी लकड़ियां नीचे गिराती है और मेल को कहती है कि आप इसको पकड़ के लाओ. हवा में ही ये जो है पकड़ने के लिए कहती है वंस ट्वाइस थ्राइस इट इज डूइंग लाइक दिस वन. देखो आप जो है ये करती है मेल और ये लकड़ी छोड़ती है ऊपर से, इसको एफर्ट करती है कि ये पकड़ने का जो है इसके अंदर देखे. व्हेन शी सेटिस्फाइड देन ओनली शी इज मेकिंग द फ्रेंड्स. सो दैट इज कमिटमेंट एंड स्ट्रगल. ये अपने बच्चों को हाईएस्ट लेवल से नीचे गिरा देती है. जब भी उड़ने योग्य होते हैं गिरा देती है कि नाउ यू गो. सो द स्ट्रगल अकॉर्डिंग टू स्ट्रगल स्टूडेंट्स हैज टू बी चेंज्ड. एक हाइव स्पिरिट और दिखाना चाहता हूं मैं आपको. जो है शहद जो बनता है ना, एक शहद की जो मक्खी होती है साइज ऑफ दैट वन आदमी से साइज उसका शायद 1/1 lakh होता होगा. बट द माइंड विच शी इज हैविंग इट इज मच मोर देन ह्यूमन बींग. ये जो हाइव दिख रहा है आपका, this angle with horizontal is 130 degree. Always every hive is having angle 130 degree. ताकि शहद जो है नीचे नहीं गिर जाए. And second one, always it surrounds that one. It is maintaining temperature of that जो जो honey जो है, in honeycomb temperature has to be 35 degree Celsius. जिससे viscosity कम नहीं होनी तो वो नीचे गिर जाएगा. First angle it is providing 130 degree with horizontal. Another one for maintaining the viscosity temperature always is 35 degree Celsius. और ये इसको घेर के रखती है जिससे temperature change नहीं हो जाए. And not a single drop of honey they are consuming. So finally, believe the purpose of life is to serve. जो purpose of the life, particularly for the teachers, is to serve. जब हम जीवन से में यहाँ पे आए थे, nothing we have brought and when we will be leaving, nothing will be taking away. So this type of spirit among the students we let to create. They should be engineers. Our target has to be engage them, inspire them. And involve our students. Involvement of the students is foremost. And greatest sign of a greatest teacher is, even if teacher is not in the class, if teacher is outside, 100 students are sitting in the class, if they are engaged, without teacher, if they are engaged, it means teacher is great. Unki absence mein bhi agar students utna hi badhiya se role ada kar rahe hain, it means teacher is a great teacher. And sharpen your axe. Do view dikhaye hain maine. One side I've shown. जो जो आपकी बटरफ्लाई है. अनदर साइड जो जो कैटरपिलर्स हैं, कैटरपिलर्स आर फाइटिंग ईच अदर एंड बटरफ्लाई अलोन. व्हेन वी आर असेसिंग दी स्टूडेंट्स डोंट असेस देम व्हाट डोंट कंपेयर देम ईच अदर. जस्ट यू कंपेयर हाउ मच ही वाज हैविंग नॉलेज अर्लियर एंड हाउ मच इज हैविंग टुडे. 7 days बैक व्हाट नॉलेज ही वाज हैविंग, टुडे व्हाट इज हैविंग, आफ्टर 15 days व्हाट इज हैविंग. सो value addition daily, how much value addition is there. So competition with himself has to be, not with the others. Aap students ko aise assess nahi kariye ki tere ko kam aata hai, tere ko zyada. No, aapko ab kya aata hai, baad mein kya aata tha. Just I'll be finishing, 2 minutes I'll be finishing. So this type of assessment of the students has to be, individual students has to be assessed ki aapne jab is college mein admission liya tha tab kaise the, aaj kaise ho, saal baad kaise hoge, 5 saal baad kaise hoge. It should not be compared with other student ki wo kaisa tha, wo kaisa ho gaya. No, competition should be with ourself, not with the others. That is just like butterfly, not just like caterpillars. अच्छे टीचर के साथ अगर रहते हैं तो योग्यता बढ़ती है. अगर वही अच्छा बच्चा खराब टीचर के साथ रहता है, योग्यता is going down from 90% to 30%, 7%. So role of teacher is very, very important. Earlier classes which we were having, that was teacher centric and we were pushing the knowledge. The learners were outside, the teacher was in the center and it was being pushed. Now the classes which we are having, the learner is inside. He is pulling the knowledge from every source. And somewhere teacher is there, somewhere Google is there, somewhere journal is there. So from every source it is extracting the knowledge. So it is now pull type knowledge. Earlier it was push type. Teacher was pushing everything to the students. Now the student is pulling from every source. We people are how we are helping in engaging these type of classes. The studio from where I'm speaking, we are live streaming the content, the knowledge which we people are having, or we are inviting experts.